The time is 11 after 11 on November 11th. The time we call Remembrance Day. Well, some of us anyway, apparently not here in India. I visited a cenotaph at the former St. Francis, former St. Bartholomew or Benedict or something, Portuguese, founded by the Portuguese, Vasco da Gama's remains were buried there for 14 years before his son returned them to Lisbon. Now I'm sitting in front of the Chinese fishing nets, remembering the soldiers, the sailors, the flyers, the resistance, vive la resistance, and also the untold victims whose lives never were able to meet that potential, who lived in sadness and fear, who had to run, who had to relocate, the refugees, the parents, all of you, I remember you today. I've made my poppy. It's a red one. Sometimes I wear a white poppy because the best way to acknowledge war and honor the sacrifice is by doing everything we can to prevent further war. It seems in these days in the world, that's a nigh impossible task. And it's easy to justify wars as just or needed against despots. But who really is the despots? That's only for history to decide. And death is death and is death. We can't be responsible for killing people simply for reasons that have nothing to do with them, that they didn't ask for. Short people on the list, people get excited. It's easy to get all jingoistic and opportunistic about war. But death is death and death is final. And sadness and the opportunity cost of not being able to live a full life because you lived in a time of war is something that I abhor. I'm a fortunate man, I'm 46 years old, and I have not died in a war. I have been affected emotionally by war, but never physically. I've been affected by physical violence and chaos, but not by war. I've worried as others, my dear relations, have been affected by war and have been into war zones, and I worry. I worry about stuff like that, right? But today I'm here to remember as I sit in front of Chinese fishing nets on Mahatma Gandhi Beach, of all places. Mahatma Gandhi traces his lineage and his political thinking right back to my hero, old Henry David Thoreau, whose folks just called him Dave. And I'll celebrate the life of Henry David Thoreau by working to be civilly disobedient when needed, to find the side of being morally correct, not necessarily legally correct, and to thank Henry David Thoreau each time I use a graphite pencil. But to all of you who have been affected by war and all of you who stand in solidarity with me, understanding the importance of doing everything we possibly can through diplomatic means and through nuance and understanding other people's psychology, their needs, their wants, and for admitting the past errors of the races and cultures that we belong to. The word reparation, often people think it means something about money. It's not. It's about respect, it's about acknowledgement, it's about not repeating the same mistakes. This breaks my heart to see traditional peoples all over the world, rights trampled in the name of progress, in the name of money, in the name of greed. Well, you know what? Integrity wins over greed all the time. It's easy to say, oh, love wins out over war and all that, but we have immediate needs as human beings. And in order for us to climb up Maslow's hierarchy of needs, to find some sense of self-realization, first we need to fight. We need to work diligently to help other people meet their own potential. We can't work towards our own self-interests. We have to work towards the self-interests of the people around us, the people who are less fortunate, the people who don't have the means to fight. There I did it again. To struggle. Vive la resistance. I stand on the side of peace. I stand on the side of diplomacy. I stand on the side of education. I stand on the side of compassion. On this 11-11-11-11 from Kerala, India.